CEO of the National Research Foundation. Mr. Tom D. Powell, Chairman of our Governing Board and also Chairman of the Public Utilities Board of Singapore. Mr. President Su Ralin. Distinguished guest, Governing Board, Scientific Advisory Board, other distinguished guests, and ladies and gentlemen. I'm Kerry C., and I'm the Director of the Earth Observatory of Singapore, and I welcome you here to our opening ceremony. Today we're celebrating the realization of a vision shared by the Singaporean government and people to study and forecast natural phenomena threatening Southeast Asia. We're deeply grateful to the National Research Foundation, to the Ministry of Education, for funding the observatory. We're also indebted to President Su, to Provost Anderson, to the faculty and students here and staff at NTU for wholeheartedly supporting its conception and its birth. A few weeks ago around the corner, I came across a poster stating global warming is one of the greatest threats that our Earth faces. That statement, as well-intentioned as it was, betrays a profound naivete with respect to our relationship to Earth. We Earth scientists, many of us here are Earth scientists today in the Science Advisory Board, we know from the mysteries that we've ferreted out of the rocks and the sediment and the ice that far more severe changes have occurred throughout the multi-billion year history of Earth, and in fact through our own two million year evolution. A more accurate statement would have been to say, global warming is one of the greatest threats that human civilization has ever faced. Indeed, natural hazards such as earthquakes, volcanic eruptions, tsunamis, and global climate change are a major category of threat for our young 10,000-year-old civilization. The first few years of the 21st century have provided ample evidence of our vulnerability and our exposure. The devastation of Aceh and Thai coast in 2004, Kashmir and New Orleans in 2005, the southwest coast of Java in 2006, Sumatra again in 2007, Myanmar, western Sichuan in 2008, comprise a nearly incessant litany of death and loss and suffering. In some of these cases, we knew that we were living on dangerous ground. In other cases, we did not. New Orleans had been known as a catastrophe waiting to happen for decades. But for a variety of reasons, we failed to do anything about it. Similar incongruities exist here in Southeast Asia as well. By contrast, there are places sitting in the jaws of a dragon that have no scientific awareness of the tenuousness of their existence. Such was the case of the hundreds of thousands who perished in Aceh. These tragic examples, one of basic ignorance and the other of the inability to translate knowledge into action, illustrate well the challenge of acquiring basic scientific knowledge of natural processes and then utilizing it effectively and in a timely fashion. The Earth Observatory is well positioned to face this challenge. We intend to blaze new paths through the fascinating mysteries of this dangerous, dynamic, thin shell of a planet that we call our home. We also aim to be modern scientific high priests, if you will, illuminating those marvelous phenomena and their attendant perils to our fellow sojourners, civic leaders, engineers, planners, and many other well-intentioned, talented, and energetic individuals and organizations working to make the world a safer and more enjoyable place. In a few minutes, it'll be our pleasure to introduce you to the observatory and guide you on a tour through it. But first, I'd like to introduce a gentleman to whom we owe a great debt of thanks for his efforts to make the observatory a reality, NTU's President Su Ralin.